Brad Blakes. I've got the beautiful Ashley Green here. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I love the hair. It's flowing.
Thank you.
In the movie, you don't have, like, flowing, luscious hair.
No. Alice is known for her pixie cut, but I think I was having kind of identity crisis about my long hair.
In the whole, this love triangle that we're looking at between the three, how do you fit into it? I mean, you're the sister and the confidant to Bella, but how would you explain yourself in this love triangle that's sitting on the side?
Alice is actually in love with Jacob. Ooh. And no, I'm kidding.
Jesus, I was going to say, I didn't pick a... I'm like, I'm a terrible gauge of love stories.
Alice is, you know, she's obviously more, I think, a fan of Edward because she's his sister. But Alice is, you know, kind of the first Cullen other than Edward to embrace Bella. And she becomes best friends with her and kind of, I think, just tolerates Jacob because she cares so much about Bella that she does realize how Bella feels about Jacob and the fact that, you know, Jacob would do anything for her and he really does care about her safety.
But is there a chance where you maybe get to see Jacob with his top off?
Like, I think everyone does.
Oh, right, okay.
Yeah, I think everyone's going to be happy with the second movie, if not because of the acting and scenery, at least Jacob has.
The scenery, right. Were there moments where you were, like, having a coffee, you just, it's cut, and you're sitting there, and you look up, and there's Taylor walking around with, in skimpy clothes and stuff, and you're like, what the heck has this kid done?
All the guys, I feel like, walk around without their shirts off.
Oh, right.
Yeah, I'm just like, all the werewolves never have clothes on.
Right, so they're just naked.
It's a hard job for me.
Right, it is a hard job for you. Well done. Now, being the sister of Edward Cullen, that's a pretty big responsibility, really. And you have to, do you think you have to guide him through his journey?
I wouldn't say guide, but I think, she's definitely there to kind of, banter back and forth off. I think they have kind of a special relationship because she can see the future and he can read minds, and so it's kind of a fun dynamic because we can kind of talk to each other without even having to speak to each other. But I think, Alice is kind of just, she loves Edward and the rest of her family to death, so she's kind of always going to be that shoulder to lean on in that positive factor.
If you were just walking down the street, the normal, beautiful girl you are, and you had a choice of between a wolf man or a vampire, which one would you really want to kiss?
I would probably go with the vampire.
Really?
Yeah.
You love vampires?
I do love vampires.
What turns you on about vampires then?
I just... maybe it's because I play a vampire and we refer to these werewolves as dogs.
Yeah. It's a bit mean.
I didn't write it. I think there's this kind of... they're sexy and they're mysterious and they're kind of almost unbreakable and untouchable. And it's really intriguing.
Well, it's a pleasure to sit here in front of you. Did you read my mind at all?
Yeah.
What was in there?
I can't say that on TV.
Oh, sick stuff. Oh, jeez. All right, you're a champion. Well done, darling.